Mayer's report is a report that of contrasts. I think that is something that we can say clearly. On the one hand, the drug use appears to be relatively stable, with levels of use remaining high, but not rising overall. And in some important areas, such as cannabis use by young people, recent data show even some positive changes. We estimate that Europe has more than 1.3 million regular opioid users. Overall, levels of use have been stable for some years now, and we observe an aging group of users and reduced levels of drug injecting. However, the illicit use of other opioids, other than heroin, both pain medicines and substitution drugs, has been identified as a growing problem in some areas. Trafficking. We estimate that between 10 and 20,000 regular opioid users die each year in Europe, and the risk of dying for them is 10 to 20 times greater than for their non-drug using peers. Over the last decade, cocaine has established itself as the most commonly used stimulant drug in Europe. We estimate that about 4 million European adults used cocaine last year, though high levels of use are only found in a few countries. New data suggests that the popularity of this drug might have peaked in some high prevalence countries, and recent surveys show a decline. We see that new substances and products are continuing to be launched on the marketplace, with the internet as one of the main sources for supply. Preliminary results from our 2011 snapshot exercise identified more than 600 online shops selling psychoactive products to clients in the European Union. I'm sure that in the future we will see synthetic drugs of all types playing an increasingly important role in the drug problem we collectively face. But to a large extent, our policies and our responses are still configured to the need of the last decade. We now need to make sure that they are fit for our current and future challenges.